Good morning. Now we are going to see the experiment on Power Electronics and Drives Laboratory, that is second experiment, characteristics of SCR. So aim of the experiment is to determine the VI characteristics of SCR, that is silicon control rectifier. The apparatus required for this experiment is SCR, regulated power supply, voltmeter, ammeter, then ammeter of that 0 to 30 milliamps and the range of ammeter 0 to 100 micrograms. Then resistor of 1 kilo ohm and 560 ohm, then come some connecting wires. So the circuit diagram of a SCR. So we know that the thyristor is one of the most important type of a semiconductor devices. They are extensively used in the power electronic circuits. So a thyristor has the four layer of the semiconductor structure, that is PN and PN structure with the three PN junctions. So it has three terminals, that is anode, cathode and the gate. So it has three terminals, anode, cathode and gate. So it So different forms of thyristors are classified. So they are called as silicon control rectifier, triac, diac and gate turnoff thyristor. So now in this experiment we are going to discuss about the VI characteristics of SCR, that is silicon control rectifier. So the silicon control rectifier is a four layer terminal device with that fourth layer with a three terminal device with the junctions of J1, J2 and J3. So the construction is that a gate terminal is kept near the cathode. So if you can see that anode cathode, then near the cathode we are having the gate terminal. So that it has the thickness of each layer with the doping densities. So in this SCR, we are going to see the experiment of VI characteristics. So this is the SCR VI characteristics trainer kit. So as per the circuit diagram, the connections were given, and with that connections we are note down the readings that with the shown in the display. So you want to note the readings. So the procedure is to determine the characteristics of SCR. You want to make the connections as per the circuit diagram, switch on the supply, set the gate current at a fixed value by varying RPS on a gate cathode side, then increase the voltage applied to anode and cathode side from zero until the breakdown occurs, and note down the breakdown voltage and draw the graph between anode to cathode voltage as well as the anode current. So this is your traveler column for SCR, that is to mark the cathode voltage as well as the anode current as well as your gate current. This is your model graph. So in this VI characteristics, we know that it will have a two mode of operation. So that is that forward blocking mode and reverse blocking mode. So forward blocking mode, for each positive current is applied, the thyristor will transition and it will break over onto the state will occur at the smaller values of the anode to cathode. So once the thyristor is in on state, the gate cannot be used to turn on the device off. So the only way to turn off the thyristor is for the external circuit to force the current through the device to be less than the holding current. So we are having the various cathode and anode voltage with the anode current. So in this we are having two major components of current, that is holding current and latching current. So that holding current is that it is after an SCR has been switched to the on state, a certain minimum value of anode current is required to maintain the thyristor in slow impedance state, so that if the anode current is reduced below the critical holding current value, the thyristor cannot maintain the current through it, and so it also it is off state. Usually it is associated with the turn of the device. Next one is the latching current. So after the SCR has switched on, there is a minimum current required to sustain that conduction period. So this current is called as the latching current. So this latching current is always is usually greater than your holding current. So by using the connections and that readings, we are now going to note down the different values of your anode and cathode voltage, then anode current and your gate current. So by using these values, you're going to plot the graph, that is for a gate voltage and the anode current and also that anode cathode voltage. So by using that readings, you're going to plot the graph. So thus the characteristics of SCR and output waveforms were obtained. Thank you.